गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। सो आई वॉज ऑन द चैप्टर अ टर्किश जज। दिस इज़ अ वेरी नाइस फोक टेल। दिस स्टोरी इज अबाउट द कैलिफेंट कैदी दैट हाउ अ जज हेल्प द हेड ऑफ द स्टेट। सो लेट्स रिकैप्चुलेट दैट वन डे वॉट हैपन। द कैलिफ वेंट एज अ कॉमन ट्रेवलर टू Basra. There he saw what? An old man. He was sitting on the roadside. So the old man asked for help. And the caliph helped the old man. So they both traveled to Basra on horse. And when they both reached to the town square, the caliph told the old man that get off from the horse. But what did the old man told? No, you get off. I won't get off from the horse. This horse belongs to me. This is my horse. So now caliph was very sad. Yes, because he know very well that this horse is mine and he don't want to lose the horse. So and what did the old man told? That I know that you are true. This is your horse. But we both are a stranger here. Who knew that whose horse is this? So it's better to give me this horse. Now the caliph was in a very difficult situation. He was thinking that if he forced the old man from the horse, then the mob will gather. And if he give his gold coins to the old man, then the old man will get chance to cheat again and again to other people. So he was thinking about it. So at last, what does the caliph decide? He decide that now we will go to the Qadi of Basra. Qadi of Basra means to the judge. Now he will only decide that whose horse is this. So they reached there. Now what happened there? What they saw? They saw that an oil merchant and a porter were there. They both, the oil merchant and porter, were in the court. And who was holding the court? Qadi. Who was Qadi? The judge of Basra. And what both were saying? Both were saying that the piece of gold belongs to them. Your Honor, so now let's start. So they went to the place where the Qadi was holding court. Two men stood before Qadi, an oil merchant and a porter. In his hand, the porter held a piece of gold which he claimed was his. Your Honor, said the oil merchant, that coin belongs to me. I have owned it for many years and always carry it. I lost it today. Are there any witnesses? Asked the Qadi. No, Your Honor, answered the man. So now they both reached where? They both reached to the court. And who was holding the court? Qadi. And the piece of gold was in the hand of porter, which he was saying that it is his. And then the oil merchant told that coin belongs to him. He owned it for many years. So the Qadi asked that any witness. So what did the man reply? No, there is no witness with him, as you can see here in the picture. The Qadi asked the man to leave the coin with him and to return to the court the following day. Following day means the next day. The caliph was puzzled and he wondered how the Qadi would pronounce a just decision. The next case was called and two other men approached the Qadi. So now the Qadi asked the man to leave the coin with him. Now the coin is with whom? With Qadi. And he told both of them to return to the court to the next day. Now the caliph, he was puzzled. That means he was thinking that how he will take a decision, how Qadi will take a decision that whose coin was it. Now next case, another case was called, and the other two men approached the Qadi. What is your trade? He asked the first. I am a writer, answered the man. Now this is the another case of other two men. So he asked, what is your trade, to the first man. So the first man replied that I am a writer. Why are you here? Continued the Qadi. So the Qadi asked that why are you here? This morning while I was out, someone stole my book of learning. That tailor, he said, pointing to the other man, now has it and claims that the book is his. So the writer, what he said that when this morning he was out, when he was out, his book of learning was stolen. And who stole the book? The tailor. Now the tailor is having the book and he was claiming that it is the book of the tailor, but the book is mine. Did anyone witness the tailor stealing the book? Asked the Qadi. No, your honor, replied the man. Now the writer replied, that means the first man replied that he did not have any witness that the tailor has stolen his book. Very well, said the Qadi. Leave the book with me and return tomorrow. Now again what? Again the Qadi said, now leave this book with me and you come tomorrow to the court. Next, the Qadi called the caliph and the old man before him and inquired why they come to the court. Now next chances of whom? Caliph and the old man. Dear children, just see, first who were there? Oil merchant and porter reached to the court, and what was there? About piece of gold. Whose piece of gold is this? Oil merchant or the porter? Now the next case was of a writer and a tailor. What? That whose book of learning was it? Now the third one is who? The caliph and the old man. Your honor, said the caliph, I am a traveler from a distant land. This man asked for my help, and taking pity on him, I brought him with me to Basra. When I asked him to dismount, he refused, and now he claims that my steed is his. So now both caliph and old man turn came, and now the caliph told to the Qadi that he is a traveler from a distant land, and having pity on the old man, he thought of helping the old man, and he brought the old man to the Basra, and now the old man claims that his horse is of old man. The Qadi then turned to the old man. What do you have to say in your defense? Now, what did the Qadi do? That now it's old man turn. Now you have to say, the horse is mine, your honor, answered the old man. I have cared for him since he was a colt. What is the meaning of colt? The baby of horse. If that horse is taken from me, how will I live? I am old and feeble. I can barely walk. I need my faithful horse to carry me. Here the old man wailed and forced false tears to gain the sympathy of the Qadi. So now, what did the old man spoke? He spoke that, your honor, this horse is mine. And he started crying, just taking the sympathy of the judge. that this horse is mine. How I will be able to live without this horse? As I am old enough, I can barely walk, and I need a faithful horse who will carry me. And he just spoke what? He lied to the Qadi. The Qadi calmly asked, "Have you any witness?" "No, Your Honor," replied the Caliph and the old man together. So now Qadi asked that both of you, have you any witness? So both of them replied, "No, we don't have any witness." Then said the Qadi, "Leave the horse in my stable and return to the courtroom tomorrow morning." The same answer he gave again, which he have given to both two more cases before, the case of the oil merchant and porter, as well as the case of writer and tailor. He told same to them that, "Leave this horse in my stable, and now you have to return when? Tomorrow morning." The next morning, the Caliph arrived at the courtroom early, for he was keen to hear how the Qadi would decide the case of the coin and that of the book. Now, Caliph arrived very early to the courtroom because he was taking as an interest that how this Qadi will judge that who was right and who was wrong. How he will decide that whose coin was it, oil merchant or porter, and whose book was it, of a writer or a tailor. As soon as the Qadi entered the room, he ordered the oil merchant and the porter to come before him. Handing the gold coin to the oil merchant, he said, "Here is your gold coin. Take it. It is rightfully yours." Now the Qadi entered the room, and then his first case was of whom? Oil merchant and porter. He told oil merchant and porter to come before him, and he gave that gold coin to whom? To oil merchant, and told him that this is your coin. You have to take this. Then he returned to the porter. "You have tried to keep what did not belong to you," he said in a stern voice. Stern means in a serious voice. What he told that this was not your coin, and what you were saying that it was yours. "Soldiers," he called, "take this man away from the courtroom and see that he offers his services free of charge to the oil merchant for a month." So what punishment was given? So what punishment was given to the porter that he have to offer free services to whom? To oil merchant for a month. Next, the Qadi called the writer and the tailor before him. "This book of learning belongs to the writer," he said. "I now return it to him." "But, Your Honor, I swear that is mine," protested the tailor. Now, the Qadi, that is the judge, called his next case, whose writer and tailor before him, and gave that book of learning to the writer and told him, "Just take it from him." And what did the tailor do? He swore and said that, "No, this is mine." Again, then the judge said, "Soldier, take this false swearing tailor and ensure that he pays the writer 5 gold coins for the trouble he has caused him," ordered the Qadi. So what punishment was given to the tailor? That he have to pay how many gold coins? 5 gold coins. To whom? To the writer who have put in the trouble. To whom? To the writer. This was the order of Qadi. So up to here we have completed. Next remaining part we will complete in next class. थैंक यू।